Hello and welcome. Today I'm going to show you how to convert a WebP image into multiple different formats, such as PNG, JPEG, and GIF. And then I will show you how to convert all of these formats back into a WebP file. The process of converting a WebP image does not require any software downloads or installs of any program of any type. We also do not need to install any Chrome or Firefox browser add-ons to do such a simple task. Okay, let's get started. I'm going to go out to the web and download a WebP file to show you how to convert between these image types. I'm on Zillow right now and I'm going to download one of these pictures and we're going to start working with it. First, locate your WebP file. For me, it's in my downloads folder. You can go to yours and follow along with these steps. Okay, now if we click on the file, it opens in the browser as a WebP file. So I'm going to close that. Now the first thing you want to do is go over to the View tab and look for file name extensions. It should be in the ribbon under the View tab, and put a check mark in file name extensions. Now we can see the file name extension. Let's convert this to a PNG file. So highlight it and then click rename. And then on the .webp part, take out webp and put in PNG. And then click outside of the name and you'll be presented with the rename confirmation that you could possibly break your file, but you don't need to worry about it. So just click yes. Now you can open this up. I'll select edit. Okay, and it opens in our default editing program, which is Paint. And you can see that the whole picture is there. It's uncorrupted. So let's close the window now. Let's rename this to a JPEG now. Right click on your file, select rename, change the extension to JPEG, and click outside. Confirm the rename change. And then you can right click on it and open it in your default editor again.
I'm gonna skip the conversion process from WebP into GIF and back to WebP just because I think you have a pretty good idea now of how to convert the files. All we do is change the extension and basically it's a rinse and repeat process until we get the image type that we want.